Okay, so understanding where to listen for heart sounds anatomically and then what those heart sounds correspond to physiologically is very important. So let's go ahead and dive in and we'll discuss heart sounds, where to listen for them, and exactly what they mean. So the five heart sounds we're going to listen to are aortic, pulmonic, Erb's point, tricuspid, and mitral. Okay? So let's go over what those sounds are, and then we're going to look at it more physiologically, kind of what's happening within the heart. So the mnemonic I like to use for those five heart sounds is ape to man. A-P-E, 2-T-M, man, okay? So the A for ape represents aortic valve. And to listen for the aortic valve, we're going to listen in the second right intercostal space on the right sternal border. Okay, so that's right here. So here's our sternum. So the right sternal border is just right to the right of that. And it's the second intercostal space. So 1, 2. So the second sound we're going to listen to is the pulmonic valve, A-P-E. Okay, pulmonic valve is going to be the left sternal border, second intercostal space. So to listen for our pulmonic valve, we're going to move our stethoscope right over here, over the left sternal border, second intercostal space. And that's going to correspond to our pulmonic valve. All right. And again, same thing here. We're listening for stenosis or regurgitation based on what's happening and where we're hearing our murmur. The next place we're going to listen to is going to be our third intercostal space, right along the left sternal border. That corresponds to Erb's point, so A-P-E, Erb's point. What Erb's point tells us is that's the best place to listen for our S2 sound. Okay, with our S2 sound, what we're listening to basically is we're listening for the closure of the aortic and the pulmonic valve. So the best place to listen for that is going to be along the sternal border as well, in the third intercostal space. So 1, 2, 3, and that's where we're going to hear that. From there, we're going to move on to our tricuspid valve. Okay, so tricuspid valve is going to be between the right atria and the right ventricle, and that's where we're going to hear that tricuspid valve. It's going to be fourth intercostal space along the sternal border as well. Okay, so A-P-E, 2-T, and then man. Okay, so to listen for our mitral valve, we're going to go the fifth intercostal space, mid-clavicular line. So here's our clavicle. Right along the center of the clavicle in the fifth intercostal space. Again, our first heart sound is going to be the aortic, right along the sternal border, and we're going to hear that right here. Okay? And then our pulmonic is going to be second intercostal space as well, along the left sternal border. So you can kind of see how those line up. Erb's point, best place to listen for S2, which is closure of aortic and pulmonic valve. And you can see how that's going to kind of, so 1, 2, 3. That's going to kind of line up right here, right where you can see these two valves passing, okay? So you can kind of see where these two valves are. And we're going to listen kind of right over it. And that's going to give us the best place to be able to listen for those two valves closing. All right, and then for our tricuspid, we're going to go fourth intercostal space. So it's going to be about right here. You can see that's kind of where we're going to be able to hear it, fourth intercostal space. And then for our mitral valve, we're going to go fifth intercostal space, mid-clavicular line. So right about here. But what these heart sounds and the locations of these heart sounds are going to tell you, and this is why it's important to understand this, because what these are going to tell you is this is going to tell you exactly where the murmur is occurring within the heart. Okay? So if you hear a murmur over the right second intercostal space over the midclavicular line, that is an aortic murmur. Okay? So you're going to be hearing this aortic valve as you're listening right there. So that's the best place to hear that murmur and identify that murmur. Now, if you hear a murmur over the fifth intercostal space, mid-clavicular line on the left side, that's going to be a mitral valve murmur, okay? So those are the best places to listen for those murmurs, and understanding where we're listening and what we're seeing on those is going to tell you exactly what you're hearing. Okay, so to understand exactly what's going on with these different valves and these different murmurs, we'll just kind of talk about this really briefly, because again, we've done a couple different longer videos about different murmurs, but we need to understand what each valve is doing during systole and what each valve is supposed to be doing during diastole. Okay, so again, if we hear a murmur over the midclavicular line on the left side, fifth intercostal space, that's going to be a mitral valve murmur. Okay, where's our mitral valve? Well, it's right here. It's between our left atria and our left ventricle. So what should our mitral valve be doing during systole? Okay, during systole, our mitral valve should be closed, right? Because our aortic valve is going to open and push blood out into the system, while our mitral valve is closed, allowing that blood to push out, okay? By closing this mitral valve, aortic valve opens, pushes blood out, okay? So a systolic murmur, a murmur occurring during systole over the fifth intercostal space, left midclavicular line, right? That corresponds to our mitral valve. And if that is occurring during systole, well, what should our mitral valve be doing during systole? It needs to be closed. Okay, so a systolic murmur of the mitral valve is going to be regurgitation, right? Stenosis is when the valve doesn't open and blood is not able to get through. Regurgitation is when the valve doesn't really want to close. It's an incompetent valve, and so blood is pushing back up. So a systolic murmur, the mitral valve should be closed. So if it's not closing, blood is going to push back up into the left atria. All right, that's going to represent mitral valve regurgitation occurring during systole. And you're gonna hear it over the fifth intercostal space, midclavicular line, right? Okay, now if you hear second right intercostal space, that's going to be an aortic valve murmur, correct? Because this location, the second intercostal space, right sternal border, corresponds to aortic valve. Okay, and again, what should aortic valve be doing during systole? Aortic valve during systole should be open, right? Blood is going to be forced, squeezed out of this left ventricle, pushing it out into the system. Okay, so if we're hearing it during systole over our right second intercostal space, okay, that's gonna correspond to our aortic valve, and that aortic valve should be open. Because it's not opening, that's stenosis, right? When it's not opening, it's stenosis. When it doesn't close appropriately, that's regurgitation, okay? So if we heard a murmur over the aortic valve during diastole, that then would be regurgitation. If we heard it over the fifth intercostal space on the left side, midclavicular line, that'd be mitral valve. And the mitral valve during diastole should be open, right? During diastole, blood is going to be squeezed out of this left atria into the left ventricle. If we're hearing a murmur at that point, it means that mitral valve is not opening. And during diastole, it should be open,